Welcome everybody. My name is Lefteris. I will be presenting the paradox of centralized tools doing accounting for decentralized finance. It's a very big title, but an interesting topic. So, first of all, about myself, if you don't know me, I'm Lefteris. I have been in Ethereum since 2014. I worked on Solidity and the C++ client, then worked a bit in Slowkit, and then I have been working in Rhino as a core developer, and at the same time I have made Rootkit, which is a portfolio tracking and accounting software. The talk will not be technical. It will be presenting essentially this paradox of what I see as a paradox, that we use centralized tools in order to do accounting for our decentralized world. I will try to ponder on what the reasons for this may be, present solutions in the way forward, and then towards the end hone in on the one solution that well, I'm biased towards, which is Rootkit, the application I'm working on. So what's the problem? Probably everyone here has done it before. Like you have cryptos covered over multiple accounts or multiple blockchains. You trade in crypto exchanges. You maybe got paid in crypto. You maybe played around with DeFi. Maybe you even mined. And then at some point you need to find out where is what. You maybe need to get your private keys. See how much profit you made, how much you lost. So I guess you would just go to Google and start Googling crypto accounting software or portfolio tracking, and you would get some solutions like this. This is a tweet by Paul Berg, which happened in the last month. And we have here a list of various accounting solutions for crypto. Here is an overlay of the same tweet with what I see as the problem. Essentially, everything in there is a centralized software as a service solution. Except for the one I'm going to talk about today, and two more. Actually, one is not here. I discovered it after the tweet. I say this as something bad, but I would like to analyze why. It's not just because the word centralized has a bad meaning. It depends. For some things it's good. For some things it's not the best fit. Performs the taxes, and then you configure the software accordingly. I just learned yesterday that for the American users, the IRS made a new pretty cool FAQ that essentially makes it very nice for you guys. It's not only fee-for-leaf anymore, but you can minimize. So you can maximize or minimize, you can choose whatever you want. So this is something that we have to implement. It's not yet in production. So, there's also a premium version for those who want to support the development that has graphs. So for example, here is the net value over time graph. This is a typical crypto holder who was not smart. And this is the same crypto holder. It's basically test data, but it's essentially just the typical crypto curve. This is the asset amount, this is, BTC. So the net value of this guy is BTC, and then the amount of BTC. So this guy was smart here, he sold his BTC on the top and then started buying when it started falling again. There are more charts, but I'm not going to analyze this further here. Yes, so this is like another chart that we have a distribution of your entire net value on assets. So this guy has a lot of tokens. This is just a pie chart on how they're distributed. So, what's the name for the project? I'm a backend developer, I don't know anything about UI, so the current UI is like an abomination of JavaScript, jQuery, Bootstrap, and some other stuff. And my friend Kelsos here is basically doing a rewrite in Vue.js, so proper maintainable UI. Thank you, Kelsos. And we want tighter integration with decentralized exchanges and DeFi, so essentially, we probably want to start with Kyber, Uniswap, and then probably also Compound. If the project gets traction and support, probably an Android companion application is also on the horizon. And generally, if anybody of you wants something from a portfolio tracking software, please approach me, Twitter, GitHub, whatever, and give us feedback. You can try it by visiting the GitHub repository. not show you, this is the GitHub link in this huge QR here. It's open source, this is one of our biggest strengths. So please, if you like the idea of open source software and of owning your own data, please help us. If you know Python, TypeScript, Vue.js, PRs are more than welcome. And if you are not, if you're just a user and want to try it, even if you don't like it, don't just try it and leave it. Please give us feedback, valuable feedback, even if it's negative. We will only get better through this. If you like it, on the other hand, open source software needs help. So we have a premium subscription. So this is, you can purchase a premium subscription. And what you get is these charts and more features as we are progressing. You also get support in, not support, yeah, priority in the feature requests. And of course, premium support. For example, the Coinbase integration came through a guy who essentially just wanted Coinbase and got a premium subscription just so that he can get Coinbase integration. It's like a small monthly amount, I think like $10 per month, and of course crypto is accepted. Just recently I also became accepted in the GitHub sponsors program, so this is another way to help the project. So just sponsor me in GitHub, and there actually GitHub will match the sponsorship. So whatever you provide, GitHub will provide the same amount. So that's pretty cool on their side. And you get some small things like a Kickstarter thing, like there is tiers and stuff. And generally, the best support will be users. So if you guys want to use it and want to try on your data, just try to use it and give feedback. I would like to close with this tweet by Snowden. He essentially says that there is no question that there is a list anymore. Everyone is on it. The only question is, where is your position on the list? So do not feed the list of the big man further. Do not use centralized services. Thank you, that's all.